Now we are going to see the elimination method concept clearly with the help of example 11 in your textbook. Okay, so the example 11 is the ratio of incomes of two persons is 9:3 and the ratio of their expenditures is 4:3. If each of them manages to save rupees 2000 per month, find their monthly incomes. Okay, so in this problem there are two persons. Okay, they have given their salaries and expenditures ratio. Okay, so we have to find the monthly incomes. Okay, so let's we move for the solution. Here they have given two ratios, one is income ratio and expenditure ratio. Here we are going to deal with the variables x to be the salary or income. Okay, then the variable y to be the expenditure. Okay, so they have given the first person income ratio is 9 and the second person income ratio is 7. Okay, so the income is dealt with the variable x. So the first person salary can be assumed as 9 into x. So let the salary or income of first person be 9 into x, that is 9x. Let the salary of second person be, they have given the ratio 7, so it is 7 into x. Okay, so these are the salary representation of both the persons. Okay, now go for the expenditure section. Let the expenditure of first person be, they have given the ratio 4:3, so it is 4 into y. Okay, then let the expenditure of second person be 3 into y. Okay, so next see the third condition. If each of them manages to save rupees 2000 per month, so here income means the salary they are getting. Okay, then the expenditure means the money they spend for meeting their necessary things. Okay, so here it is the savings. So the savings for per month is rupees 2000. So it can be represented in a tabular column. You will understand clearly. Let me take the tabular column. First person, second person, here the salary, then the expenditure, then savings. Okay, so savings is salary minus expenditure. Okay, so savings means salary minus expenditure. So the salary of first person, it is 9x. Then the salary of second person, which is 7x. Then the expenditure of first person is 4y and the second person is 3y. So it is expenditure of first person 4y, expenditure of second person 3y. Clear? They have given that each month they are saving rupees 2000 after the expenditures. So which means that the savings of the first person is given by salary minus expenditure. So salary minus expenditure, that is 9x minus 4y. Clear? Salary minus expenditure gives the savings of first person. Okay, then go for the second person. He is also saving rupees 2000 per month. So his salary is 7x and his expenditure is 3y. So it is 7x minus 3y. So 7x minus 3y gives the savings of the second person. Okay, so these are the tabular representation for the given scenarios. Clear? Now let me move for the conditions they have given. Now see here, savings of each person is 2000 per month. So it can be written as 9x minus 4y. So 9x minus 4y. I am considering the first person's savings. Okay, so 9x minus 4y is equal to 2000. Okay, so according to this condition, 9x minus 4y is equal to 2000. Then go for the second person. He is also saving 2000 rupees per month. So his savings is represented as 7x minus 3y. So in the equation form, 7x minus 3y is equal to, he is saving 2000 rupees. So it is 2000. Okay. So these are the two equations we have framed. With this, we are going to find the values of x and y using the elimination method. Okay. So in elimination method, in the first step, we have to bring either the x coefficients or y coefficients to be numerically same. So in this sum, I am going to make the y coefficients as numerically same. So see here, in first equation, okay, so let me multiply the first equation by 3, because here the y coefficient is minus 3. So we are going to multiply it by 3. The first equation by 3. Then take the second equation. Already it is minus 3. Okay, y coefficient is minus 3. Then we are going to multiply with the y coefficient, that is 4. Okay, so I am multiplying equation 1 by 3. So 3 into 4 becomes 12. Then I am going to multiply the equation 2 by 4. So 3 into 4 becomes 12. So the y coefficients are numerically same. For that sake, I am doing this operations. Okay, so 1 into 3, which means equation 1 into 3, that is 3 into 9x minus 4y is equal to 3 into 2000. If you are multiplying the equation by 3, then we have to multiply on both the sides. That is why I am multiplying 3 into 9x minus 4y is equal to 3 into 2000. So which gives 3 into 9x, that is 27x minus 12y is equal to 3 into 2000 gives 6000. Okay. So let me name it as number 3. Okay. Now consider this. Equation 2 into 4. So we have to multiply the equation 2 by 4 on both the sides. So it is 4 into 7x minus 3y is equal to 4 into 2000. So 4 into 7x, it is 28x. 4 into minus 3y, minus 12y is equal to 4 into 2000, 8000. Let me name it as number 4. Now look at these two equations, 27x minus 12y is equal to 6000, 28x minus 12y is equal to 6000. Here we have bought the y coefficients to be same, that is exactly same, that is they are having the signs are also same. It is minus 12, here also it is minus 12. So in the second step, just we have to subtract these two equations in order to cancel the y terms. Okay. Then subtracting equation number 4 from equation number 3. So first write the third equation. It is 27x minus 12y is equal to 6000. Then fourth equation, 28x minus 12y is equal to 8000. We are going to subtract this equation from this equation. Okay, so if we subtract, the signs will become changed. Here it is plus, here it is plus, so it will become minus. Okay, So the signs are changed because when we write this equation, for example, 27x minus 12y minus 28x minus 12y. If we write like this, when we multiply this minus sign to the bracket, it will become 27x minus 12y minus 28x, minus into minus become plus, so plus 12y. See here, in this equation the x coefficient is plus 28, but here it is minus 28. Then see the y coefficient, it is minus 12, but after subtracting it is getting to plus 12. So the signs are changed. That is why we are going to change the signs if we subtract these two equations, because this minus sign is multiplied into this bracket. Okay, so when we do like this, the signs will be changed. If it is plus, then it becomes minus. If it is minus, then it become plus. Okay, that is why we are changing the signs while subtracting. Okay, so 27x minus 28x, it will become minus x. Then minus 12y plus 12y, it will be cancelled. So the y terms are cancelled. Then minus x is equal to 6000 minus 8000 gives minus 2000. Okay, so minus signs can be cancelled on both the sides. So x is equal to 2000. Thus we have got the value of x. Then substituting, x is equal to 2000 in any one of the equation. Let me take the equation number 3. 27 into x, that is 2000, minus 12y is equal to 6000. 27 into 2000 becomes 54000, minus 12y is equal to 6000. So 54000 minus 12y is equal to 6000, minus 12y is equal to 6000 minus 54000. Okay, so minus 12y is equal to minus 48000. So y is equal to minus 48000 divided by minus 12. When this minus 12 goes here, it will become the denominator part. So I am writing minus 12 here. Okay, so cancelling this minus signs, then 48000 by 12. So 12 fours are 48. So it is 4 followed by 3 zeros. Y is equal to 4000. Okay, thus we have to find their monthly incomes. So we assumed the monthly income of first person to be 9x and the second person to be 7x. So after obtaining the value of x and y, the monthly income of first person is 9x. So 9x means 9 into 2000. So 9 into 2000 gives 18000. So it is rupees 18000. Okay, then the monthly income of the second person is 7x. So 7x means 7 into 2000. So it is 14000. Clear?